Hey guys, it's Jennifer DeVivo with the DeVivo Real Estate Team, and I am here with your summer market update. We are going to be talking about how Orlando is growing so crazy. So this episode is for you, especially if you're a renter, because right now people are saying, Jennifer, rents are going crazy. And yes, Orlando is tracking rent at twice the national average. Orlando is adding 60 to 67,000 people per year, which is breaks down for the Central Florida area, 1,700 new people coming into the Orlando area every week. And we have numbers like unemployment is at 2.9%, a super tight job market with low interest rates. So what's going on in the Orlando market? How is it going to affect you? What should you do if you're buying or selling? We have got answers and solutions for you. So you know how we do. We break down the numbers first. Right now, we have 7% more homes on the market than we did last year. I know it doesn't feel like that, but we have 8,050 homes on the market right now. But supply is not keeping up with the demand, with growth, which we're going to talk about. And also, the median price of a home, people want to know, what is the average price of a home in Orlando? It's $250,000, which is 5% more than last year. But what people are telling me, Jen, if I want to get the home I want in a great community, I'm really looking at the $300,000 mark. And so we'll talk about some strategies because affordability in Orlando is shrinking, home supply is shrinking, population growth is growing. So what do we do? And there's a rental shortage. And for the first time in a long time, I have a lot of renters calling me, say, Jen, I know you don't do rentals, but please help me out. I do have some rental lists, and people are just crying. My landlord just raised all the rents. What's going on? What are they trying to do to us? Well, I will tell you right now, unfortunately, Orlando is number one when it comes to lack of affordable housing for low and middle income families. That's just what's happening right now. And so people are like, should I buy? Should I build? And we're going to talk about that. In the Orlando market for rentals, right now, we don't have enough supply. Is there gonna be more supply being built? Yes, there's more apartments coming in, there's more builders coming in, but there are obstacles. Right now, the unemployment rate is only 2.9%. So it's really tough to get those people who build, you know, our construction workers, our contractors, are really super busy. So there's a really tight market when it comes to building. Also, people don't realize that the crash of 2008 really affected builders. After the crash, builders pulled back. So we have about 200,000 to 300,000 unit deficit in terms of keeping up with the demand. The Economic Development Council of Orlando that watches all of that, the EDC, said Orlando is its own animal when it comes to growth. 50% of the people who are coming into Orlando are coming from out of country, out of state. You probably already knew that. The demographics are really, really changing, and Orlando is just bursting at the seams. So what do we do with the rental market? In addition, some of the cities like Winter Springs and Claremont are shutting down developers who want to do multifamily. The cities in Orlando like Claremont, Witcher Garden, Ocoee, Kissimmee, they're trying to control the growth, which is good, but it's making it really tough for our renters. So a lot of times people are like, Jen, getting a rental home right now is first month's rent, last month's rent, deposit. And guess what, guys? There are a lot of special programs that you can do in terms of using that money, $3,000 to $5,000, to buy a home. So definitely look through my channel. We have classes every month on Saturday for down payment assistance programs. We can help you get $10,000, $20,000, $30,000 to help you buy your first home if you're renting, if you haven't been a homeowner in the last 3 years. Because guys, this is not going anywhere. Orlando is one of the fastest growing markets in the country, and rent just keeps going up. So you're gonna have to move out a little bit. Then there are affordable areas. People are like, Jen, where can I move that's more affordable? Well, the reality is if you wanna be in the Orlando Central Metro area, you're gonna have to downsize. You're gonna have to think maybe townhome, maybe two bedrooms, maybe a little smaller, because Orlando families, the median income of an Orlando family is not keeping up with the housing price, the median price of a home. It's just outpacing it. It's just supply and demand. So don't forget there are resources. We have the Florida First Bond Program. We have the USDA program. The Florida First Bond Program can give you $7,500 towards buying a home. The USDA program is a zero down program. And we have county programs. What you don't know, possibly, is that you can use these special programs to purchase new construction. So we're in a beautiful new construction community right here, and we are in Claremont. So it's a possibility that this is located in a USDA zone. So that's zero down. So if we put that together with one of our programs, and we put it together with, a lot of times the builder will give you incentives. They'll give you $5,000, $10,000, $15,000 towards your closing costs, towards your upgrades. We can get you into a home for the same that it might cost you out of pocket to rent something. And then be not sure if the rent is going to keep going up, if you're going to have to move again. And that's just stressful, guys. Once you buy a home, you're locked in. So I always have a heart for my renters. And I say to them, look at your rental property, not as your dream home, but as an investment and a buffer against what's going on with the economy. When you purchase your home is going to act like an insulator. So as property prices rise, your equity is going to rise, and so is your property value. Also, it's going to protect your pocketbook, because you're going to be able to lock in your taxes. And also, what I really, really love, renters, is that you can write off up to 60% of each mortgage payment, okay? So at the end of the year, when you're doing your taxes, it's like your landlord comes to you and says, here's 60% of all of your payments back to you. What is not to love about that? So don't be afraid. I know buying a home is not for everybody, but it is the fastest, quickest way to create generational wealth for yourself, for your children, so that you don't get priced out of the market. And so definitely give me a call. Find out about our special programs. Again, the first Saturday of every month, we do a special first-time homebuyers class. You get a certificate. It's valid for up to 2 years, and you can tap into these programs, and you can tap in to new construction. So guys, I want to address the biggest question, elephant in the room, that comes to me again and again. I hear it over and over again. Is the bubble coming? Will it burst? I feel like 2008 is around the corner. Well guys, something like 2008 happens once like every 30 years. We do see normal ups and downs in the market, and people want to know, Orlando's hot, it's growing, prices are going up. Is there a bubble in the Orlando market? And I'm going to say there's some indicators, part numbers. I'm not just going to say no because I'm a realtor. One of the biggest drivers, there's three drivers I want to kind of talk to you about what the bubble constitutes, part of a bubble. One of the biggest drivers in the Orlando market is that 2007, 2008, I was doing real estate, and I remember having an investor who bought 15 units, just sat on them, waiting for them to appreciate so he could resell them. Those are called speculators. Speculators buy up a lot of investment property and property in an area, and they sit on it, and they think they're going to be able to flip it. Well, what's driving the market in Orlando is not investors, but they are people who intend to live in the home, people who want it for primary residence, landlords who decide to put actual families in the home. That's what's driving the Orlando and the Central Florida market. We're not seeing a lot of speculators driving the market. So that's number one. Number two are tight lending standards. And I'm telling everybody, I just refinanced my house and I had to give a DNA sample, my firstborn child, some of my blood. It's an intrusive process. And the reason is that during the crash, if you had, and I say this always, if you had a social security number and a pulse, bam, you are approved. So lending practices are still very tight. You need to document everything. You need to provide all of your statements, your tax returns, your bank statements, your 401k, all of those types of things. Not everybody is just getting a loan. So that's the second indicator, that we still have very tight lending standards. One of the third indicators in Orlando is the growth and the low unemployment rate. We have businesses coming into Orlando. We have foreign nationals. Half of our market is coming from South America, Canada, China, Brazil. We have all of the colors of the world here in terms of like different nationalities, and it's a beautiful, wonderful thing. But what it's causing is an impact on the demand and the supply. So we just have 67,000 people coming in every year to Orlando. That's going to affect the housing market. And these are people who are planning to live, stay, work, and play. So those would be the three things that I would tell you in terms of, are we in a bubble? I don't believe we're in a bubble. People ask, how long is this going to last? That the market is growing, I would say at least the next 2 years. Every time that there's an election year, which is around the corner 2 years from now, things go a little crazy. People are not sure what to expect. But you can count on a really strong and growing market. In my opinion, it's for the next 2 years. So that summarizes my take on the summer market for Orlando and Central Florida. If you're a buyer, what I would love you to think is to get ahead of the market. Do not sit on the fence. You're going to be priced out whether it comes to rent or whether it comes to values. There's a lot of special programs. Definitely contact me. I even have a link down in the notes for my down payment assistance portal. You just put a little bit of information in there and it's going to give you a list of all of the programs that you could qualify for. If you're thinking about selling your home, don't time the market. You know, sometimes we have ups and downs. The summer is obviously the best time to put your house on the market and sell. Christmas time tends to be great for buyers who want a deal, but don't sit on the market. Now is a great time to sell your home and then think about possibly buying something, or even just keeping your home and thinking about getting a great vacation investment property right now. You're in Orlando, ground central, top vacation spot in the universe right now. So think about that. And if you're an investor, according to Forbes magazine, one of the top four areas for investment. So many different types of investments here in Orlando. You can do vacation, you can do Airbnb, you can do 12-month regular rental, you can buy a lot of new construction, and we can have them rented for you with a lease before the house is even finished being built. So a lot of great choices if you're a buyer, if you're a seller, if you're an investor. So reach out to me. Don't be afraid. I just don't do videos to have fun. I do have fun doing them. I'm an actual realtor and I would love to help you. So give me a call, 407-921-1310. You can connect to me all over social media, on YouTube, LinkedIn, Facebook, Instagram. Leave a comment, leave a heart if you liked it. I would love to connect with you. I would love to reach out to you. And if you want to just search for homes, go to my website. We've got tons of resources. You can search all the new construction at jenniferdevivorealty.com. We have a search for all of the down payment assistance programs. If you're a veteran, we have a special page just for you. We have the VA Heroes Loan and several special programs for veterans, because I know a lot of veterans are coming to Orlando to retire, to relax. So connect with me at jenniferdevivorealty.com or give me a call, shoot me a text, 407-921-1310. We are here and we are ready to help you find your way home. Bye, guys.